Colin and Meena Desai.
We are Colin and Meena, very excited about to be here. Thank God to Kanti and Lata that we were introduced to this business. Otherwise, I don't know where would have been, you know. And it was almost 20 years ago. You know, time flies, you know. I know some of you were not even born when I got started. Okay. So those of you having to wait for 20 years, somebody is born today is going to be sitting here, you know. So that's why we never saturate this business, you know. Because every day new people comes in the market, okay? Right? So the supply never ends. So it's the best opportunity, okay? And what we're going to talk about is, you know, tell you, you know, give you a little bit of my background. I have a pharmacy degree, also an MBA in finance marketing. Used to work for a bank as one of the vice president, you know. And I didn't know whether I needed this business or not, you know. And it's like, you know, when you are sick, you know sick, you go to doctor. But when you're sick, you don't know you're sick, what do? You know, that's the worst situation to be in, you know. And so that's where we were, you know. But thank God, friend of mine brought me to Kanti and Lata, and we got to see the plan. And she decided to join. Now I'm a finance major, you know. So I say, let me double check. So I check my bank balance. There was not much in it, so I said, okay, let's do it. There was nothing to lose. But that was 20 years ago, you know. But then there is a journey from there to where we are today. You know, it wasn't that, you know, we were overnight wonders or, you know, successful overnight or anything. We had to go through a lot of different things, you know. A lot of things had to do with us more than anything else, you know. A lot of things we had to overcome, you know, in order to achieve the success that we have. And we continue to do that because we haven't arrived yet. Okay? So we had to overcome a lot of things, but there was mainly circle around us. You know, everything had to do with us, you know. So we had to do a lot of things. And I'm sure some of you probably going through or will go through some of the things, you know. The biggest thing I had to overcome was my status, you know, because I was VP. You know, and had a big status issue, you know. Now, I don't know whether you heard or not, but there's a definition I used to hear long back. I didn't agree back then, but I totally do now, you know. What's the definition of status, you know? It goes like this, that, you know, you buy the things you don't need with the money you don't have to spend the to impress the people you don't like it anyway. Okay, let me repeat that again. You spend the money on the things that you don't need and buy with the money you don't have to impress the people you don't like it anyway. That's called status, you know. And you know, that's what I had. I know some of you have it or not, probably you, when you have it, you don't know it. When you get rid of it, then you know you had it, you know. So that's the problem, you know. So, and, you know, when I came to this country, I came with $20 in my pocket. You know, knowing nobody, I didn't owe anybody nothing. I was not broke, you know, I had 20 bucks, you know, right? And I still have that 20 bucks in my pocket. The rest of that money, Meena has, but, you know, it's another story, you know. But then, you know, I came in positive $20, and all of a sudden I was owing a lot of money. I was in a debt. I said, what happened, you know? And it wasn't actually my fault, you know, actually it was my neighbor's fault, actually, you know, because they were buying the things I couldn't afford. I know some of you will get it on your way home, you know, because you come home from work, I say, you know, our next door neighbor, I say, I know them from long. They bought a new car. I say, okay, I'm a VP, I need to get a new car, you know, and that's how things start, you know. But thanks God for this business. We learn a lot of opportunity. And, you know, today both our children, you know, Mona is sitting here, Kavan is here with his wife Anjali, you know. We are all doing, there was nothing I could have done, we whole family could have done together. Mm-hmm. And Kavan and Anjali, both are actively building the business. They are new 1500 PV this month, you know. Moving on, going on to silver and joining the club, you know. Mona is right there, you know, following into his, you know, her brother's footsteps, you know. But to accomplish this, we have to overcome so many different things. And I'm going to go list few of them. One I already told you about status, you know. And only way to get rid of it, realize you have one and get rid of it. It's just like, you know, how do you cure alcoholism, you know. You admit you are alcoholic. That cures everything, you know. But if you don't accept it, you have problem, you'll never look for a solution. Okay, so all this area I said, you know, financial, see, check your status yourself. How am I doing? You know, this is your opportunity. Okay, but it's not going to be as simple as that. You're going to have to work on so many different things. But before I continue, I want to have Meena come and share a few things with you. Because without her, I wouldn't be standing here, to be very honest with you. Okay, because she's the one being a strong supporter. Of, you know, when I had to overcome a lot of my personal challenges, mainly my problems were, you know, I had to overcome my time challenge because I was very busy professional. I used to work from wake up 5 in the morning, come home late evenings, you know. And, you know, they don't give you that title and money to go with it just for no reason, you know. And you know, as Kanti was saying, they suck your blood, you know. You just don't know it, you know. And it's true, you know. And so that did create some time challenge, but I had to overcome that, you know. So I had to work my schedule around it, do something, you know. I was already working 7 to 8 hours at work. On top of that, I had 20 hours to this business, to build this business. Honestly, to successfully build, you'll need that much time, okay. So now it created a more situation because I had no time and now I have not even the in time which I had, little bit time with the family on Saturday, Sunday, that's gone too, you know. And that creates a lot of situation, you know, a lot of internal guilt, you know. Hey, I'm not spending time with my kids, you know, whole week I don't get to see them. Just I got them on even Saturday, Sunday, I used to at least save them. Now I don't do that because I'm out building the business. And it's just not you, around people around you going to tell, you know, your brothers and cousins and everybody who is negative, oh, you don't care about your kids and you after money and all that. They don't tell that right now. They call me lucky right now. Okay? But they don't know. Now, I could have gotten that guilt feeling and not do. That's time Meena came in. And so, you know, I understand. Because you're doing for the family. And but if she started also doing that, oh, you work whole day and you come home, then you go out to show the plan and you don't care about us, and then we wouldn't be on a stage. Okay? And, but that, thank God that, you know, she was the one. Matter of fact, when I wanted to stay, I said, oh, whole week I'm not here with kids. Let me stay. She said, no, go out. They don't know. You know, they'll know when they are 16 and they want new car. That's when they'll know. And that's what it is, you know. Your kids, you have a small, Meena will talk a little more about it, but, you know, I had to work on all those things, you know. It wasn't quite easy, but hey, if your dream is big enough, facts don't count. Okay? So here is Meena.
Thank you. Thank you. Welcome everyone here. Well, my overcoming was different than Kulin, of course. One of the first important thing was the sleeping hours. I remember when we joined the business, I used to sleep like 9:30. I had to be in a bed. And then I realized that after 8 o'clock, the business starts. So for me, going to bed 9:30 was a situation for me. And then for plus, I had to have like 7 to 8 hours of sleep. When we were building the business on a fast track, it was not possible for me. And then I heard from somebody that if you wanted to double your sleep, you just put the carbon paper under your pillow and then you got your double your sleep. So that's what I have to do it, and I did it, I guess. But now I can sleep more than 8 hours if I want to, you know. So that is one of the most important thing for me was go to sleep 9:30. But now I don't go to sleep 9:30. 1, 2 o'clock, I can still awake and make it happen, you know. And the second thing was like Kulin was talking about the children. And I remember when I joined the business, I was pregnant with my daughter Mona, and Kavan was just 5 years old. We used to go out building the business, and all the friends, family who were not building the business, feeling me guilty that, oh, all you are doing, you know, leaving your, how can you leave your children? it's this small age, you know, but I know why we were going out. I always remember that. Why I have to be feeling guilty, you know? Because Kulin knows why I'm going out. He is the one who's telling me to go out. Then why I have to feel guilty if somebody's telling me about? So I think I say, well, for me, he is the one who's going to tell me what I need to do, what I don't need to do. I don't want to hear from other people because I remember, as Kulin was talking about, he used to be a VP at the bank, and I remember right now the way the economy is happening, and I don't think he would have a job right now because of the way he was making money and at a higher level. At this level, I don't think he would have a job. And I'm thank God I didn't listen to our friends and family. If I would have listened, do you think they would listen to me right now? I don't think they would listen to me. Oh, I don't have a, Kulin doesn't have a job. Can you support me? Things like that, you know. But I'm glad whatever I needed to do, whatever the situation I had to overcome. And the most important thing was when they were growing up, our children, I have participated them in only one activity per year. And I remember some of the friends and family, their children were like having more than one activity. And I remember their mothers were moving around with their children as like a limousine driver, you know, one place to another. And then I say, oh, am I doing the right thing? And then I remember our early days, you know, when we were growing up. Back in India, I didn't participate in any activity. That doesn't mean I doesn't allow my children to do the same thing. But I turn out to be a good kid. So I say, well, whatever I'm doing okay. And not bragging about our kids, but I know they are all sitting here. I love Kulin. I love them, and not only that. I know they are not perfect kids, but I know behind the back they are always a good kids. I can give the guarantee. But by doing that, I know, of course, when I remember when the year we were going diamond, we sat down with Kavan and Mona, and they said, this year we are very busy, we are not allowing more than one activity. But they said, this year don't worry about any activity. This year we are not participating in any activity. And guess what, after that, it's like a history, you know. After that, I remember all the Kavan was on a fast track, and whatever Mona wanted to do, all the games he was playing, I know Kulin was always there, you know. So I highly recommend, you know, some of the people make you feel guilty, but you know what you are doing. That's what we have done it. And another last thing is, you know, status, what Kulin was talking about. I remember I didn't have a status. But sometimes when your husband has a more status, sometimes more than husband, wife has a more status, because wife doesn't have her own status. So she uses the husband's status. So then I was thinking that he's a VP, and if I would have think that, okay, at the VP at the bank, why we needed to do this kind of business? Because in the beginning, I remember when we joined the business, we did not have that many successful people from the gala organization who could have come and told us how this business have done for them. And we did not have that many success stories in front of us. But we still did it. And I always remember I wanted to do it, the business of my own. And I put the Kulin status on the side, and I say, whatever we needed to do for our life and for our family, we are going to be doing it, you know. And the last thing is the overcoming, you know, any level, whether you started building the business in the beginning or any level you are in the business. Exactly 5 years from now, we had exactly this period of the time, we had a fire in our house. And we were not here, we were not in New Jersey, we were out of town, and we got the news from Kanti and Lata. And that is the, I see those kind of things, and we came next day to our house, and we saw the house was gone, nothing was there. I have seen those kind of things in the movie. I never thought that this thing could happen to us. But situation do happen. What can you do? But we didn't sit down and, okay, we started crying and, oh, what we'll do it now. And next week, we had a schedule to go to the Canada to serve our Canada team. And we decided, we were planning to go as a couple to serve our team. But then we say, well, everything is gone anyway. We have to do shopping anyway, you know. So we decided to go as a family and have a fun and serve the team. And that's how we went. So all I wanted to tell you is, situation do happen in the life. As long as situation doesn't become an excuse in your life. With that, I wanted to bring Kulin over here because he is the one who makes things happen for us and whole our family. With that, here is Kulin. Thank you.
All right, guys. So, you know, I know you're going to have a lot of different things, but I'll tell you, I had a thing to overcome was fear, because I know fear is something, you know, we all have a different level, but we all do. Different kind of fear. I fear of people, you know. What would they think? What would they say, you know? And that would stop me from talking, because in this business we have to, you know, we have to talk to people, you know. And that's, you know, because of something called fear of rejection. Okay? What if they say no? You know, I had to realize that I'm offering something, I'm not asking something in the back. So I need to create that belief in a business to know enough that when Kanti told me about the business, you know, he wasn't asking for help, he was offering me an help. It didn't seem originally that way, but later on I realized, today I thank Kanti more than you can even think. You know, what if they wouldn't have not offered me? Okay. So when I had to realize that, to remove that fear, I had to realize I'm offering something. Say they don't take it, it's not my, I don't have to feel guilty about it. I should feel guilty if I don't do it. It's like I always say, use an example that if you know CPR, and if you saw on the side of the road somebody's really suffering through heart attack right now, and you know that CPR can help, and if you know how to do it, would you be afraid of people and say, no, what would they think? Or would you go and apply CPR? Right? Same thing, you know people are suffering, is worse than heart attack right now. The financial attack people are going through, you know? And you know the solution. Why wouldn't you offer it? Okay? It's the exact same analogy. Okay? And that's what I take. And after I realized that, I start talking to everybody. I had to overcome that fear. Okay? I had to overcome, there's a book I can recommend, Overcoming Rejection Will Make You Rich. Okay? You need to read that book, understand what the rejection is and what you need to do that, you know. Any networker, you know, most rich people in the world build network. And only way you can build a network is if you overcome that fear of rejection. Okay? Work on that. Okay? I have to fear of failing. What if I don't do and succeed? You know, I didn't want to do the business because I didn't understand. No, I got the plan. Business. When you show somebody a plan and if they don't get in, not that they didn't understand, not that they don't have dream. It's wrong. This is the two fear controls them. Fear of failing and fear of other people. And fear of, rejection. So when I show plan, I talk about these three things. Initially when I saw this thing, these are the three things that were stopping me from doing it. They'll immediately understand, oh, I have it, so I can do it too. So whatever their excuses are, if you can predict ahead of the time and use it in your presentation, if you take care of people, excuse before, to them it's a reason, but they are actually excuse. If you take care of excuse before it becomes an excuse, you'll have a better chance of succeeding. And that's the thing I had to overcome, okay? And as I said, you know, I also had to, what would they think? You know, the committee of they, right? All of you have it too, What would my relative will think? What would my, neighbor will think? What would my, in-laws will think, all of those things, because, I was hoping for approval in that sense, I didn't think when I was working overtimes and working longer hours, and I didn't think what they think, Because then they say, oh, that's good, you like any one of us, I had to work on that. Time challenge I talked about, I had to work on my time challenge, okay? I had to worry, another challenge I had after business, I had to handle emotional thing after people join in a business, you spend a year or two with them, with that you become close and they quit on you. They quit on their dream. So I had to handle that, And I had to understand that I can't take responsibility for somebody succeeding and I cannot take responsibility for somebody failing. But sometime in this business, you get a test. All you can do is lead people away if they succeed on their own. Raj and Sangeeta, they are double diamond in the business. I can't take any credit for it. Okay? We have Suresh and Sandhya, we have Girish and Purnima, Dalpat and Sudha, we have Kanti and Anju moving on in business. All of them are succeeding because of they want to succeed. I am just a vehicle. Same way I have a lot of people, even family, they come in and they quit. they quit on their dream. I had to handle that rejection in the sense, you know. So you have to go through this thing. This is part of the business. Okay. In short, I want to tell you, you know, maybe you may have to face something different than I have to. Okay. But make sure you don't take your problem. See, don't throw away the solution and keep the problem. Let me repeat that. Don't throw away the solution and keep the problem. You have a time problem, don't make that an excuse. Solution is this, okay? So any situation you have to face, to get it done. Get it done, enjoy the lifestyle. Because I had a problem, I made that problem a solution. Reason. And that's why we are here, and I know you can do it too. God bless you. Go Diamond, come join us.